Welcome back. Our next guest is one of my favorite people of all time. It is my sister, Sarah. Sarah Hilton has been a nurse for almost 20 years, and she has worked in many different situations. She's worked in emergency rooms in Chicago, and she's worked in skilled nursing facilities, and she has worked to educate patients in pre-op situations. So she comes very highly recommended by in the medical community, and of course I love her, and welcome Sarah.
Thank you for having me.
So Sarah, tell us, on a scale of 1 to 10, how nervous are you right now?
An 11.
It's all fun. It's just between the girls. Yeah, right?
It's a good thing that we're like, it's a good thing I'm such a, like, I'm so ridiculous, because then there's like really, like, the bar is super low.
We just couldn't be more different that way.
I know, right?
But it's totally good.
It was fun seeing you guys walk up the street earlier. Like, oh my God, they're sisters. I didn't realize Sarah was her sister.
I know.
That was perfect. Yes. Yeah.
So
you
funny.
Have that smile that lights up the room.
Oh, thank you.
And I'm sure you do that for
your
patients
very
too.
Sweet.
That's true. You are a good.
I
have heard many good things actually about your nursing abilities. Which is what we're here to talk about today.
Yes.
So this kind of came, my idea came from an experience that I had when I was having my fifth baby, your niece Haley, and I had an IV in my hand, mm-hmm. and I kept buzzing the nurse saying, "This does not feel right," and she kept coming in going, "It's normal. An IV in your hand is supposed to hurt a little bit. Give it some time." So like 10 minutes later, I buzz her again. I was the obnoxious patient. 20 minutes later, I buzz her again. She came in. She's like super frustrated, and she's like, "What?" And I was like, "It hurts really bad." And she's like, "What do you want me to do? Like, take it out and put it somewhere else?" And I'm like, "Yeah, please. That sounds great."
Wow.
So she brought the doctor in. And the doctor says, "Oh, no wonder you were in so much pain. Your vein has collapsed and it's just going right into the tissue." And I was like, I didn't look over and go, but I wanted to.
Was she a brat as a kid too? Did she do that?
No, she never
I definitely
was.
Wanted to. But anyway, it kind of got me thinking, like, how do you tell if you have a good nurse?
Yeah.
So that's what I wanted to bring you in to talk about today. Because don't you think it would be cool to know, like, as a patient, like, do I have a good nurse or do I not?
Well, I think there's two pieces to that, is do I have a good nurse and what actually is the nurse's job? Because if I'm expecting a nurse to do something that's not a nurse's job, then as the patient, I need to be educated or corrected.
Yeah.
So I think they go hand in hand, because the proper expectation and understanding of the job then allows me to also know whether I have a good nurse or not.
That's really true. And like, am I a good patient?
That's the other part.
That's the other part.
Nobody asks that question. Nobody ever asks that question.
They don't, but it's things to think about.
Absolutely.
I mean, when you're thinking about your nurse, is this a good nurse or not? I think a nurse that's willing to say, "Hey, I may not know everything. Let me go ask and find out."
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't show that your nurse is not smart or doesn't know what they're doing. It's they're willing to accept that they don't know everything and they're going to ask for help where they need it. And
Mom, there is so
important.
Much to know. I always appreciate when people say, "I'll be right back. Let me go find out."
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, and especially because there are like an infinite amount of situations, right? And the way that different situations can pile upon themselves, I would really, that's really good to know. And it's also good for me as a patient to remember nurses are not all knowing.
Nurses are people too.
You know?
Uh-huh.
That's a good one. So somebody who's willing to go find out the details and willing to acknowledge, like, "I don't know, but I will find out."
Yeah,
that's a good one.
What else is there? There's a million.
There's a million things.
Because the truth is, nurses do everything.
I know.
I mean,
they
do.
And as far as what
everything.
Is a nurse's job,
yeah.
the nurse's job is your overall care. It's making sure you have everything you need in every aspect. So if you're ever unsure, do I call my nurse for this, or should I wait for the doctor, or ask the CNA? If there is that question, just call the nurse.
Yeah.
Because the nurse is really good at getting you the contacts you need or the resources you need.
So how would you go and call the nurse? Like, do you just call the doctor's office and say, "Hey, I need to talk to the nurse," or what do you
do? Well, it's different inpatient or outpatient.
Okay.
If you're inpatient, you'd press your call light and ask for your nurse.
That's
right?
Easy. I can do that.
And a lot of places have a direct number to your nurse as well. They carry a lot of places carry cell phones.
Oh, interesting.
But as far as an outpatient setting, you'd call the doctor's office, and almost always they will send you to a nurse or a medical assistant to kind of feed your questions to the right direction.
Oh, okay.
A lot of times they can answer your questions.
So the nurse will kind of triage those questions
exactly.
too. And then if it's like a very specialized one that the doctor has to answer, then...
And a lot of times they'll say, you know, I'm not sure. Let mm-hmm. me consult with the doctor and I'll call you back.
Okay, that's good. So back to kind of like what a good nurse is, like in my situation, would you say she was a good nurse or not a good nurse?
I mean, I've had a very similar situation.
Have you?
And when I am in the hospital or my kids have to go to the hospital, I don't tell people that I'm a nurse mm-hmm. just so that I can mm-hmm. kind of watch and see, right? Mm-hmm. But I would say it's more an experience thing.
Okay.
So if you can take an experience like that and say, this nurse just learned this valuable experience, that would be the best way mm-hmm. to come away from it rather than saying, wow, I had a terrible nurse.
Okay, that's interesting.
Because a lot of people, it is learning on the job too.
Okay.
It does take learning or having an experience with the patient mm-hmm. to say, wow, I won't ever do that again.
Oh, that's
so
that's
kind
good.
Of being,
I could. I was yeah. a good teaching experience.
Exactly.
You definitely were. You know she won't ever do that again.
Well, I think there is a reality that says, as a patient, we've each had different experiences also, right? You've, mm-hmm. This was your fifth child.
That's right.
This was the fifth circumstance of something mm-hmm. similar. You mm-hmm. do have your own experience to call mm-hmm. upon and to say to her, hey, look, I've done this five times uh-huh. before and never was it like this. Can you just get the doctor mm-hmm. or is there someone else I can talk to? Would that mm-hmm. be inappropriate?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they almost always they'll give you the nurse's number and a charge nurse's number, so you mm-hmm. can always go up above the nurse. Mm-hmm. I would always talk to the nurse first, mm-hmm. but if you're calling her in for the third time and your issues are not being resolved, definitely you can
you
go above and talk to the charge nurse.
The charge nurse is the manager then.
Yeah, there's uh-huh. always a charge nurse that manages the floor that day.
Okay, so what if I'm inpatient? What is the appropriate amount to buzz my client?
Before what? Before you try to get yourself out of bed?
Before like what is like appropriate, like in terms of like how often should the nurse check on you?
Yeah.
When is it just annoying to them?
Well, I think as the patient, you have to realize that your nurse has other patients, and depending on like the acuity of the floor, mm-hmm. they may have quite a few other patients.
Okay.
So thinking of that, if it's something that can wait mm-hmm. until the nurse comes to check on you, mm-hmm. I would probably let it wait.
Just let it wait? How often are they supposed to come and check on you? Does it just depend on the acuity level as
it
well?
It does depend on the acuity level. Mm-hmm. I would say I personally, it's like at least once every hour for like a basic medical floor.
Okay, mm-hmm. that's
if you're
good to know.
If you're in an emergency situation or mm-hmm. higher acuity, it's gonna be more frequently.
Mm-hmm.
But just for a basic floor, I try to at least peek my head in.
Once an hour. Okay, that's a really good rule of thumb. I didn't mm-hmm. know that.
Yeah.
Okay, that's yeah. interesting. And then like, what's the policy on medication? If somebody says like, oh, I'm kind of in pain, like what are you supposed to do as a nurse to in terms of like whether you should give them more or whatever?
Well, because I can't feel what you're feeling, it's important for the nurse to keep that empathetic mm-hmm. view of the patient, that whatever they're saying is what they're saying, right? You
right.
take it mm-hmm. as they say it. So if you're telling me you hurt, then you hurt.
Okay.
We always have a pain scale, so we can kind mm-hmm. of see that. If it becomes an issue where I feel like you're calling a lot, then I may tell the doctor, like, you might need to go see this patient.
Okay.
And reassess if the medication's not working mm-hmm. or if there's another issue going on.
Mm-hmm. Mm, that's a good information.
Yeah. I spent quite an extended period of time. Both my parents had medical issues at the same mm-hmm. time. So I was jockeying between one hospital in New Jersey and one hospital in Manhattan mm-hmm. and back and forth, both on critical levels. But mm-hmm. I found one thing, that there are a lot of nurses and nobody ever says no, right? They mm-hmm. may not be able to get to you mm-hmm. right at the time, but the biggest thing that helps is having an advocate for you there. Because
absolutely.
If you're in bed and you mm-hmm. can't get out, mm-hmm. then mm-hmm. the opportunity for someone to go ask a question on your behalf, you can pretty much stop any nurse on the floor and ask a general question.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That's a good point. So do you recommend trying to have somebody like with you? Like if you're in the hospital?
So I think that, yeah, absolutely. Because even having instructions mm-hmm. given to you, having more than one person hear those instructions
sure.
is better.
Yeah, that's yeah. true. That's a good
You're going
point.
To get yeah. more of it. But one thing I tell my patients a lot is, who is your best advocate? Mm-hmm. It's really mm-hmm. you. Like mm-hmm. you are your best advocate, and if you aren't fighting for yourself, it's hard.
Well, nobody
because
knows how you feel.
Nobody, exactly. Yeah. Nobody else knows how you feel. Mm-hmm. and everything you're going through is very important to you, but you need to make sure that all your needs are taken care of.
Yeah, sure. That's true. So Sarah, give us just like a 30, and we only have like 30 seconds, but give mm-hmm. us a little 30 second thing about what you've been doing as a nurse and what you're doing now.
So I am currently just starting to work for Osmond Marketing, which is going to be so fun. I'm really excited about that.
We're excited too.
Yeah, yes, it's going to be really great. Excited. But as far as my nursing career in the past, I've done everything. I've tried it all. I've done resource, which gives me an opportunity to go to all the floors, cardiac, emergency room, long-term care, inpatient rehab. I've tried it all. I love nursing. It's really fun. And I love that there's so much variety and I can try it all.
It takes a very special person, a very special heart to be a nurse.
Yeah.
I really believe it does. So thank you for all your care of all these people.
Thank you.
You want to wrap up with your sister?
I just want to give her a hug.
She's barely I love my sister.
You want to give her a hug?
Yes,
thanks for having me.
Aw, thanks for coming on. This is so exciting. All right, we will be right back.